The last year of TaylorMade brought us the RSI irons. There was RSI 1, RSI 2, and RSI TP. As well as slots in the sole, they also had slots in the face of the club, and that allowed a little bit more forgiveness if you were hitting the club off-centre. Now, this year the RSI 1 will continue through. That was a very good club, and that was the one really for the sort of mid to high handicappers, which offered the most forgiveness. The RSI 2 and the TP, I didn't feel kind of worked, and I think TaylorMade realised that, and now we have what's called the PSI, and that stands for Players Slotted Iron, and it's what TaylorMade call a Players Performance Iron. Now again, like the other set, there's a lot of materials going on in the club, a lot of technology that goes right down through the set and changes as you go down through the set. There are two models, there's the PSI and there's the PSI Tour, and the Tour version has slightly smaller, more compact heads with a thinner top line, but essentially it is the same club. So we're just going to try and go through the features of both of them here. I put out the four, and I'm going to start at the top of the set, because what they've done here is they've got the cavity they have before, they've worked a lot on having this Hybra cavity back design they've got now, and that's really a combination of stability and dampening in order to create the right feel and also to create the right launch conditions. The slot on the sole is still there, and that is there to allow the face to flex a little bit more in impact to get that ball speed, especially from those lower strikes on the face, which, let's face it, you're going to have a lot of with irons. And then of course on the face you've got a slot in the heel and a slot in the toe, which is there to help the ball speed when you don't quite hit it in the middle. Now the 4 and 5 iron also have a tungsten weight in the toe, and that is there just to help with the weight distribution and the forgiveness of the club. So let's see how it goes. You know, and certainly for the 4 iron, that's a very solid hit. I mean, I think the size of the head is actually pretty good for a 4 iron. If you're a better player, and I'm talking about single figures and down, you know, you're not going to be put off by this. I think it's about right for that size of club. I think if you're high single figures, you might want to maybe get a hybrid or possibly the RSI 1 iron. But with the PSI, I don't think it's the end of the world. And certainly, I feel the feel is kind of solid without been fantastic, because you know, at this end of the club it is still just a cast iron. I'll come on to that a little bit more in a minute. Moving on down, we have the 6 iron. Now this has a slightly wider sole, as you expect, but there's not quite the progressive head length change that there was in previous sets. They're all pretty standard and similar, which actually I like. I don't see why wedges should be more compact. I think, you know, better players need just as much forgiveness as anybody else, so having the same head size is a good thing, and that is a lovely size for 6 iron. I think that's flying very well. The height is very good, you know, and you'll certainly be able to, you know, get the right shaft off for you in order to get the right flight for yourselves. Now again, this has the slots in the sole and the slots in the face, and really I think this is where it really starts to come in, because you've got a slightly bigger head, and that will give that extra forgiveness too. Now this, everything carries on quite happily in the 7 iron, but then when we get to the 8, a couple of things change. You've still got the face slots on the front, you don't have the speed pocket on the bottom, and the head, instead of being cast now, is forged. So that should change the feel a little bit here, so let's see if that is the case. Well, it still feels quite similar, and that's quite a good check, because one of these things that concerns me when they start changing materials and changing constructions of the head is sometimes you lose the feel of the set. Now just because that's forged, that is feeling a little bit sharper, actually. It's kind of what I was hoping the rest of the set would feel like. It's not saying the rest of it's bad, but you know, you've gone from a cast set to a forged set. And this is actually very nice. I'm getting a nice combination of the thick line, the face slots, and the forged feel, and the sole width is generous, so you're going to have a little bit of forgiveness there, so the tapers off quite nicely, and I quite like this actually. I think this is the favourite makeup so far of the set that we have. But let's go into the wedge, because wedges I think is where you can really find out what a set is all about. So now into a forged head, no slots on the sole, no slots on the face. This is just a forged wedge, a sort of cavity back wedge if you like, with that dampening badge in the back. It's nice to see it's a good size, so they haven't really, you know, shrunk it down too much, if at all. I think this is sitting very well indeed. That's pretty good too. I mean, it's not quite up there with your sort of forged blades, but certainly it feels a lot better than it would be if it was a cast iron. I really quite like that a lot. I mean, it's 45 and a half degrees, and bar the 3-iron, every club is a half degree. They haven't really cranked the lofts up that much. It's certainly not any more than they were before, which I think is good, because certainly for better players' irons, if you start going below 45 with a wedge, you start making life very difficult for gapping, because you're probably going to want your first specialist wedge coming in at 50 degrees. So if you can have it down to 43, you're creating too big a gap that you can't really fill. However, if you do like this sort of set makeup, there's an A wedge as well at around about 50 degrees. So that would give you that transition into the wedges if that is something else that you want. Overall, I think Tillamy have done a very good job with this. I mean, it's nice to see them really pushing the boundaries with this sort of level of technology. I mean, the face locks was a good idea. I think it probably works a little better in that bigger, you know, game improvement type iron than it does in these better player irons. Having said that, the trajectory is very good, and certainly if you've been used to blades or sort of blade cavity back hybrids, then you will probably find these a little bit more forgiving. They will give you that little bit of option. Maybe isn't quite as much feel as you can get with some forge clubs of this size, some forge cavity backs. There's a lot of different options out there from different materials and different head constructions, but certainly it is an iron that's worthy of choice, and if you're a TaylorMade loyalist then, and a better player, then it certainly would be one to check out. That's all for me today. So for more reviews on all TaylorMade equipment, please visit the website at golfalot.com.